We have the first double aberration corrected microscope in the Netherlands.
I think looking at materials at the atomic scale is fascinating because there is the secret for the properties that these materials later will have in applications. So if we are not able to really look at very small structural details, we will never learn how we can modify and control and tune those properties.
This is the first microscope that can see hydrogen atoms in a crystal. These are the lightest weight atoms in the universe. And with this microscope, we can see individual atomic columns of hydrogen. And this is quite spectacular.
For us, it's a fantastic development. It will allow us to know more than many other people can actually learn about the materials we are looking into. This gives science a fantastic opportunity to learn more about the relationship between the structure and properties.
A normal microscope, they use visible light, and we use electrons. What we first have to do, we have to generate an electron beam, and then we shoot the electrons through the material. And then the energy, how fast they go, determine the wavelength of the electrons. And this also determines what is the details you can see. The faster you shoot, the smaller details you can see. Preparing samples for this transmission electron microscope is very crucial because the quality of the sample determines the final quality of the image. We have another system which contains a scanning electron microscope and a focused ion beam, and then we can see all kinds of locations on the sample, and then we can cut very thin sections out. Then we can thin it, that it's very thin, and with very thin I mean thinner than 100 nanometer, and our hair is for instance about 15 micrometer. So this is really 1,000 times thinner than a hair. And then we can put it in our transmission electron microscope and then we can image them.
In my lab at the moment, we have a very strong effort towards materials that can function as adaptable electronics with very low energy consumption.
For instance, our brain only uses 20 watt, but it's extremely efficient at pattern recognition. And if you do that with a normal computer, it costs a lot of energy.
We think that the computer of the future that emulates the brain with these adaptable electronics can deal with huge amounts of data in a very energy efficient way. The properties that we are looking into these materials, if the electronic will be adaptable or not, is crucially defined by structural properties that are at very small scales and will only be visible with instruments like the one we have now.